Daybreak is still a few hours away, but business is already in full swing at Sassoon Docks, the biggest and oldest fish landing site in the coastal city of Mumbai. It is organized chaos. Fishermen have journeyed back with fresh catch. Wholesale fish auctions are underway. Fishmongers jostle through the crowd, carrying tubs full of prawns, pomfrets, sealfish, salmons, and a plethora of other seafood. Long before Mumbai was the burgeoning metropolis it is today, its original inhabitants, the Koli fishing community, have been making their living from the treasures of the Arabian Sea for generations.
Initially, when my great-great-grandfather was in fishing, the fishing was a self-dependent thing. You know, we used to catch only for the survival. Whatever fish used to come, prawns or zawlas or mackerels or whatever, we used to dry it for the future consumption. And when the modernization started, when the prawns business started, when the trawlers came in 1960s and 70s, it was all mostly for the exports, you know. And that is why we started catching a lot for others, you know. The entire trade changed.
Ganesh Nakhwa is a seventh generation fisherman who operates three fishing boats at the Sassoon Docks. What he has witnessed in the last decade has been a drastic drop in catch because of overfishing and a market with unsustainable demands.
Consumer chooses what he wants to eat. Right now, consumer is a king, you know. He just chooses pomfret, surmai, prawns, or maybe rawas or crabs, you know. That's all he knows. They are forgetting that when fisherman goes into the fish, maybe for a 1-day trip or a 10-day trip, when he comes back with 100 kg of fish, that 100 kg of fish cannot be pomfret, prawns or surmai. My grandfather Hari Bhagat is his name. He used to always tell me that how sea was abundance with the fish. You know, we used to go for like a couple of hours and get lots of prawns in like just one shoal or something like that. And then slowly and slowly the days started to increase. Like in 80s it were like 2 to 3 days. 90s was 5 to 6 days. In 2010 fishing days were 10 to 12 days. Now the trawling is almost like 15 to 20 days.
So even though India accounts for 6.3% of global fish production, it could soon become economically unviable for Ganesh to continue in the fishing business. A large part of the problem could be addressed if the consumer is educated about what's happening in the world's oceans.
There is a massive information gap between seafood consumers. The information gap in terms of what fish to eat in what season in order to minimize their impact on the seafood. People are more than willing to do some subtle changes in their seafood eating practices. Only thing is this information is not available to them in a ready fashion.
Know Your Fish, India's first seafood sustainability guide launched in April 2017, is a monthly calendar that lists fish that should be avoided and those that are safe to eat.
For each fish, we collected whatever data which was publicly available and we listed down which are the months which the fish is known to breed. So for each fish, we have their breeding season, and then how strongly we should follow that breeding season is determined by the vulnerability score that was around. The months where we say a particular fish should be avoided, those are the months where that fish breeds or the fish which gets caught along with that fish.
मुझे एक्चुअली में प्रॉन्स बहुत पसंद है मगर इस महीने में मैं इस 2-3 महीने तक मैं प्रॉन्स नहीं खाती हूँ क्योंकि वो इस वक्त ब्रीडिंग सिचुएशन में है इसलिए मैं नहीं खाती हूँ लेकिन अब ये मछली जो है वो हम खा सकते हैं
समता अ हाउसवाइफ इन मुंबई बिगन यूजिंग द कैलेंडर मोर देन अ ईयर अगो एंड हैजंट लुक्ड बैक सिंस लाइक हर Many others have realized that it is crucial to allow marine life to regenerate and mature, since there is no single breeding season for all species of fish.
As a people who are practicing science, it's our responsibility to make the information available to consumers. And then, given the information is available to consumers, what our experience says, our consumers are generally take sensible decisions.
Basically, next month, menu change, 8th December, we're kind of trying to work with different kinds of fish. We have mahi-mahi in today.
At O Pedro, a popular seafood restaurant, Chef Hussein Shahzad and his staff ardently follow the Know Your Fish calendar. The tool has helped them work with the diverse seafood available in Mumbai and in engineering their menus around local catch.
So let's kind of try and avoid lobster, let's try and avoid Bombay duck. If we have different kinds of dishes on the menu, then we would rather use a different fish for every preparation that is on the menu, as opposed to use one fish on the entire, unanimously on the entire menu. And that kind of makes it cool for us. It makes it slightly challenging to come up with dishes, in the sense it's, and the challenge is something that we enjoy.
And the will to become conscious seafood consumers is a change that the staff of O Pedro has witnessed among its patrons firsthand.
Hi guys, I hope you like the food. Really good. Earlier, we were happy eating a fish tikka, not knowing what was in that fish tikka. All right, and that was the idea of seafood for us, and it was exotic. But today we want to know, where did this come from? What is it that I'm eating? Was it line caught? Is it farmed? Is it wild? Like, when was this caught? Is this fish fresh?
This small behavior change could result in broad changes in seafood demand and supply and would improve the health of marine ecosystems.
Like, you cannot eat mangoes in winters and strawberries in summer. Similarly, they have to understand you cannot eat pomfret 12 months. At the same time, you can't eat surmais in December and January. That's the breeding season. So once you don't understand the breeding season of the fish, you won't be allowing them to let them grow, you know. If this changes, the whole scenario of this loss-making business changes, it will be changed by the consumer demand only. If consumers start demanding travelies, barracudas, snappers, or the mackerels or the squids, which I catch across the entire year, I will be making money, you know. And once I make money, I can sustain my crew, I can sustain my business for years and years to come. And I don't have to overfish for surmai. So I think this has to come from a consumer end. And when it comes from consumer end, automatically fishermen can change. I want consumer to know the fishermen. As they know the fish, when they know the fish, they will know the fishermen. I think it can work like that.